Hello and good morning to all my dear students. How are you? I hope you all are fine and doing well. So today we are going to start with most interesting topic from the chapter Synthetic Fibers and Plastic from Science. This is chapter 3. In this session we are going to focus on the topic, that is plastic. So today, if you will look in your surrounding, you will find many things or you will find many articles which are made up of the plastic. Even though your mother, she used the plastic for storing the food items, or you use the water bottles, you bring that to the school, that is also made up of the water, or the packets of milks, they are also made up of the plastic, as well as the pickles are also stored in the plastic bottles, as well as the dry foods. So if you will look around you, for storing a food we use many articles which are made up of the plastic. We use the plastic containers because that seems most convenient, as well as the plastic, if you will consider, that is very light in weight, as well as the price of the plastic is very less. With this, it has a good strength and it is easy to handle as compared to the other metals. If you will compare a tiffin box which is made up of some other metal, and if you will compare that with the plastic, then obviously the plastic, the tiffin box which is made up of the plastic, which is of lightweight, then it is of the lower price, it is of the good strength, and it is easy to handle. Okay, so because of its lightweight, the plastic is also used in the aircrafts, as well as it is used in the cars, as well as it is used in the spacecrafts too. And if you will see, this list is endless. If we'll start counting the articles which are made up of the plastics, even though the sleepers, furniture, decoration pieces, they are also made up of the plastic. So today we are going to discuss about this most interesting topic, that is the plastic. In the earlier sessions, we have learned about the synthetic fibers, right? Then we have learned about the types of synthetic fibers. So what are the synthetic fibers? So synthetic fiber is a chain of smaller units. When they are joined together, it forms a longer chain, right? And these smaller units are the chemical units, and the longer chain, that is known as the polymer. So plastic is also like the synthetic fibers. Okay, plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. Okay, if now it is a polymer, then obviously it is also formed due to the small units, and here the small units are the chemical substances. Okay, so plastic is a polymer like that of the synthetic fibers, which is also made up of the smaller chemical units joined together to form a longer chain. Then if you will observe, all plastics, they do not have the same type of arrangement of units. Like some of the plastics, they have the arrangement of these units, these chemical units, as a linear, whereas some has the arrangement of these chemical units, that is cross-linked. Okay, so these units, chemical units, are arranged in two ways, either in a linear manner or either in a cross-linked manner. Okay, these plastics are available in all possible shapes and sizes, right? You might have observed the articles like the chair, the glass, the bucket, okay, or the toys of the toys are also made up of these plastics. So from this we can understood that these plastics or the articles which are made up of these plastics, they have different shapes and sizes, right? Then have you ever wondered that how it is possible how these articles are made of different shapes and sizes? So this is because of the property of the plastic, that is, it can easily mold. Okay, the fact is that the plastic is easily moldable, and that is, can be shaped into any form. Okay, then this plastic can be recycled, reused, colored, melted, rolled, sheets, or made into the wires. So you can remold it, okay, and you can convert them into whatever you want. Okay, you can also make the fine sheets out of it, you can also make the wires out of it. Okay, so that is why it finds such a variety of uses. Okay, one of the great example of plastic is a polythene. If you will observe this word, poly plus it in, right? So this is formed due to a combination of the poly plus ethene, right? It is one of the great example of plastic, and we use this polythene bags for many common purposes. Like if you go to the grocery shop, he put up all the stuffs which you have buyed and gave it to you in these bags which are made up, which are known as the polythene bags. Okay, so variety of uses are there. So it is used for making commonly polythene bags. Then we can divide this plastic in two types. Okay, now there are two types of plastics. One is thermoplastic and another is thermosetting plastic. So first we'll study about the thermoplastic. Okay, so you might have observed that some plastic articles can bend easily, while some break when force is applied on it. Okay, so when we add hot water to a plastic bottle, it gets deformed. So such plastic which gets deformed easily, deform means the shape of that article can get changed, that means deformation. Okay, so such a plastic which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as the thermoplastics. Okay, so thermoplastics are moldable easily. For example, the polythene and the PVC are common examples of the thermoplastics. Then there are these thermoplastics are used for manufacturing the toys, then combs and various types of containers. Okay, so thermoplastics are the plastics which get deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as the thermoplastic. For example, polythene and PVC, and this is used to manufacture the toys, combs and various types of containers. Whereas on the other side, there are some plastics which when molded once cannot be softened on heating. They cannot change their shape again. They are not moldable. Once it is moldable, okay, we cannot mold them again, and such type of plastic is known as thermosetting plastic. Okay, so two examples of thermosetting plastics are bakelite and melamine. Okay, bakelite you might have learned about, or you have heard about this word. It is a very poor conductor of heat and electricity. Therefore, it is used for making the electrical switches as well as the handles of various utensils and so on. Whereas melamine, which is another example of thermosetting plastic, is a versatile material, and it resists fire and can tolerate heat better than the other plastics. So it cannot easily deform, okay, as it is a thermosetting plastic. Though you will pour hot water into this bottle, it won't get deformed. Okay, So it is used for making the floor tiles, then kitchenware and fabrics which resist the fire. Okay, there are various uses of thermoplastics as well as the thermosetting plastics. Okay, so then we'll next learn about the properties or the characteristics of the plastics. So already we have learned what is a plastic, which are the two types of plastics. Now, as we know that we cannot think without the plastic, or if you will just look in your surrounding, you will find many articles which are made up of the plastic. It plays very important role in our life, right? But we'll learn now about the characteristics of these plastics, why we use them. Okay, so first is the plastic, it is non-reactive. So you know that metals like the iron get rusted when exposed to moisture and air. After some days you will find a reddish color layer which is formed on these iron, that is due to it gets rusted, that is because it is exposed to the air, so there will be oxidation taking place, and due to it gets corroded, right? But plastic, it do not react with the moisture or the air, and therefore it cannot get corroded easily, and that is why we use the plastic for storage purpose, as well as we used it to store various kinds of materials including the many chemicals. Okay, that's why we use plastic because it is non-corrodible, and this is one of the characteristics of the plastic, that is it is non-reactive. Okay, next property is it is very light, strong and durable. So you just talk to your parents, okay, about the types of buckets that were used in the past and what is the material of the bucket or mug you are using today. So what are the advantages of using a plastic container? So why we use it? We use the buckets, right, to store the water in it. Usually we use it to store the buckets, right? Since plastic is very light, okay, then it is strong. It cannot break, right? As well as it is durable, okay, and can be molded into different shapes and sizes, and therefore it is used for various purposes. If you will compare a plastic bucket with the bucket which is made up of the metal, then obviously the bucket which is made up of the metal, which is heavier, then to carry the bucket which is filled with the water, it is much heavier than the water which you are carrying into the plastic bucket. Okay, so as the plastic is light, strong and durable, as well as it can be molded into different shapes and sizes, we use it for various purposes. As well as the plastics is very cheaper than the other metal, therefore any person can buy it easily. As well as with this, there are widely used in industries and for household articles. Do one work, that make a list of different articles which are made of this plastic which you use in your day-to-day life. With this, the another characteristic of plastic is it is a poor conductor. Okay, so as we have learned that thermosetting plastic, it is a poor conductor of heat, that is why it is used for making the handles for the utensils, right? So as the plastics are poor conductors of heat and electricity, that is why the electrical wires have a plastic covering over it. Okay, and the handles of the screwdriver are also made up of the plastic to avoid the corrosion or to avoid its reaction with the moisture and air. So as well as these plastics are poor conductors of electricity there is a plastic coating or the handle of the screwdriver is made up of the plastic to avoid the shock, okay? As well as handles of the frying pans, they are also made up of the plastic, okay? So plastics find extensive uses in the healthcare industry also. Some of the examples, like the plastic is used for the packaging of tablets, then threads used for stitching wounds, syringes, doctor's gloves, and a number of medical instruments are there where you will find the use of a plastic. Then special plastic cookware is used in microwave oven for cooking food. In microwave ovens, the heat cooks the food but does not affect the plastic vessel, okay? These containers are made up of the plastics, and as the plastics are poor conductors of heat and electricity, therefore we use these in the microwave oven. Then Teflon is a special plastic on which oil and water do not stick. It is used for non-stick coating on the cookware. So there are various uses of the plastic, okay? Then there is also fireproof plastic. That is, though these synthetic fibers, we have learned, the synthetic fibers, they catches fire easily. It is interesting to know that these uniforms of firemen have coating of melamine plastic, which is a example of a thermosetting plastic, to make them flame resistant, okay? Because we have seen that this melamine is fire resistant and it can tolerate heat better than the other plastic. Therefore, the dresses or the uniforms of these firemen, they have a melamine coating over their dress, okay? So these are the different characteristics or the properties of plastics. Then we'll see the plastic and the environment. So obviously, though there are many advantages of this plastic, it plays a very important role in our life. With its various properties, we have learned, but it is also hazardous for the environment, okay? So when you go to the market, we usually get things wrapped in the plastics or packed into the polythene bags. That is one of the reason why plastic waste keeps getting accumulated in our house, right? And ultimately, plastic finds its way to the garbage. But disposal of this plastic is a very major problem. And why this disposal is a very major problem, that we'll see now, okay? First, that a material which gets decomposed through natural processes with the help of or with the action of the bacteria is called as the biodegradable substances. For example, the waste of vegetables, fruits, animals, they get degradable with, and who does the degradation? So the bacteria do the degradation, and in this way, these materials, when they decompose through these natural processes, are known as the biodegradable substances. But if we'll think of the plastic, it is non-biodegradable, right? A material which is not easily decomposed by natural processes is termed as non-biodegradable. You know what? The peels of vegetables, fruits, leftover food stuff, approximate time it takes 1 to 2 weeks for its degradation. If you will consider the cotton clothes or the papers, wood, they are biodegradable, but the time required for their degradation is different. Then if you will consider the metals like tin, aluminium and other metal cans, they take almost 100 to 500 years for the degradation. and they are not biodegradable. And the plastic bags, they took almost 7 years, and therefore they are non-biodegradable. And that's why the plastic is very harmful for the nature. Okay, so the plastic cannot get decomposed, and therefore it is known as the non-biodegradable substance, and ultimately it creates hazards to the environment. Okay, as this plastic takes several years to decompose, it is not environment friendly. It causes environmental pollution. Okay, and besides, the burning process in the synthetic material is quite slow. It does not get completely burned easily, and in the process it reaches lots of poisonous fumes into the atmosphere, and that is obviously going to lead the air pollution. Okay, and as these air we are going to inhale, that is going to harm our health also. Okay, now as well as with this plastic can cause death of many animals, right? You might have observed the animals when they eat the food which is in the garbage dump, right? Usually this garbage is dumped into the plastic bags, right? Now in this process of eating the food waste, these animals swallow the materials like the polythene bags and the wrappers of the food. And can you just imagine the consequence of it? The plastic material chokes the respiratory system of these animals, or it forms a lining in their stomachs and can cause the death of these animals. And therefore, we should not use the plastics, okay? So try to minimize the use of the plastic, and therefore as a student it is your duty also to create the awareness to not use this plastic in your surrounding. Then how you will start? So start from your house only. Okay, so measures to be taken, what we can do to avoid the uses of this plastic is avoid the use of plastic as possible. Okay, start it from your home only. Make use of bags which are made up of the cottons or jutes, and when you go for the shopping, as well as do the separation of the biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances. So when its time comes to dispose them, it is very easier to segregate these substances. Okay, with the help of these biodegradable waste, then you can make the manure, well as non-biodegradable waste that can be recycled and reused again. Okay, so it is better to recycle the plastic waste, as the most of the thermoplastic can be recycled. You can recycle it. Okay, so always remember these 5 principles as a good citizen and the responsible citizen. Remember these 5 R when you use the plastic. Okay, so reduce, reuse, recycle, recover and refuse, and develop habits which are environment friendly. Okay, so try to not use the plastic. Do not throw plastic bags in the water bodies or on the road. Then take a cotton carry bag or a jute bag while going for shopping, and try to minimize the use of plastic materials. Use a steel lunch box instead of the plastic one. So here we'll stop, then we'll next see the recap. We'll just revise whatever we have learned. So here we have finished with this chapter, that is the synthetic fiber and the plastic. So we'll just do a short revision of whatever we have learned here. So first, a synthetic fiber and plastics, like the natural fibers, are made of very large units known as the polymers. And these polymers are made up of the smaller units. While natural fibers are obtained from plants and animals, synthetic fibers are obtained by chemical processing of petrochemical. Like natural fibers, these fibers can also be woven into the fabrics. Synthetic fibers find uses ranging from household articles like ropes, buckets, furniture, containers, etc. to highly specialized uses in aircrafts, ships, spacecrafts, healthcare, etc. Depending upon the types of chemicals used for manufacturing synthetic fibers, they are called rayon, nylon, polyester, and acrylic. We have already learned about these four. The different types of fibers differ from one another in their strength, water absorbing capacity, nature of burning, cost, durability, etc. Today, life without plastic cannot be imagined. Be it home or outside, plastic is everywhere. The waste created by plastic is not environment friendly. On burning plastics release poisonous gases. On dumping in the ground, they may take years to degrade. This is because of their non-degradable nature. We need to use synthetic fibers and plastics in such a manner that we can enjoy their good qualities and at the same time minimize the environmental hazards for the living communities. So here we end up with this session. So do not use the plastic. Always remember the five principles when you use the plastic: reduce, recycle, reuse, recover, and refuse. Okay, and you know that one of the great activity has already started by the government of India to minimize the use of plastic. Okay, so just go through that scheme or the activity which is conducted by the government of India to minimize the use of a plastic, and as an activity just note it down in your notebook. With this I will provide you question and answers of this chapter in the PDF form. So just go through it, solve this exercise in your notebook, and whenever you will come to the school just show it to your teacher. Okay, so with this, stay safe, stay protected, and say no to plastic. Okay, and stay healthy, stay safe from coronavirus. So with this, we'll stop today. Okay.